But first, for years, Common Core academic standards for math and English have been the subject of battles all over the country. But there's also a move afoot to set new standards for science as well. And a number of states are starting to adopt them voluntarily. Special correspondent John Tulenko of Education Week reports.
It takes just 10 minutes to cross through Gillette, Wyoming. This small city sits in the northeast corner of the state, surrounded by hundreds of miles of prairie. But schools here in Campbell County are on the edge of something big, the next generation science standards.
You're going to build a strand of DNA, and you're going to decode it and figure out what that DNA actually says.
For Christy Mathis at Sage Valley Junior High School, the new standards are about learning to think like a scientist.
There's a lot of really good stuff in them. Every standard is a performance task. It's not, you know, the child needs to memorize these things. It's the student needs to be able to do some pretty intense stuff. You know, we're analyzing, we're critiquing, we're creating, we're actually doing the science.
Take today's lesson on genes. Mathis had her students pick fictional character cards with the name, height, hair, and eye color of each character.
This is a secret. Just you and your group know. Okay.
In teams, they built a genetic model of their characters' traits, and then the groups traded models.
And they're going to try and figure out who you had based on what you code for.
Okay, so orange, red, red represents what?
The eye.
She has blue eyes.
Blue eyes. What did you grasp about genetics from doing this exercise today?
That there are so many different parts of genetics that go into so many different things. Something as small as like the size of a gene, it's really, really small. It can change drastically how your life turns out.
Developed by the National Academy of Sciences and others, the next generation standards are more comprehensive than what teachers here had been using.
You might have had a teacher that liked a dinosaur unit and they'd turn it out in second grade, and then the same unit get taught in third grade and the fourth grade, and you're like, well, I know a lot about dinosaurs.
Before the new standards, middle school teachers like Mike Mahoney were left to fill in the gaps.
I'd always have to start at the nobody knew anything at the very beginning. What is science? And it's kind of tough to get into a lot of the different curriculum things that you want to teach when you have to spend so much time just on the basics.
The new standards brought more structure, spelling out for the first time what should be taught grade by grade in elementary school.
Every fifth grader is going to have this experience. Every fourth grader is going to have this experience. Then those kids come to junior high and it's not a catch-up game. You know, what'd you miss? What'd you get? What do I need to do? They're always building on what came before and what comes next.
In Wyoming, Campbell County is leading the way with these standards, which the state has yet to adopt officially. 17 other states are already on board, accounting for an estimated 35% of public school students nationwide. David Evans heads the National Association of Science Teachers.
I think that the most important reason for developing new standards is that we've actually learned a lot about the way children learn. And children learn science best by actually doing it.
So far, there's been little pushback. Unlike the Common Core, there aren't yet state-level science tests to hold schools and teachers accountable. And the federal role's been different, too.
The federal government and Department of Education really hasn't had anything to do with the next generation science standards. It's really just that simple. There haven't been strong incentives, and there hasn't been any arm twisting.
But these new standards still have a long way to go.
There's an established line of data right now that documents the fact that that we're not spending very much time teaching science in elementary school.
Nationwide, schools spend 143 minutes a day on math and reading, but only 20 minutes on science. And there's another big concern.
The majority of elementary school teachers don't feel comfortable teaching science. Most elementary school teachers don't receive a lot of preparation in science itself or in science education.
So how does the light travel?
To help its teachers, Campbell County is using a federal grant worth just under $1 million to develop new lessons for every grade. Jamie Howe teaches fourth grade.
I've learned to step back and let their exploration take over. Mm-hmm. And before, you know, you'd always want to help them and guide them and tell them what the answer should be. So I've had to learn to step back and let them be in charge.
Nice job, guys.
We got it.
That's Gillette, a good-sized city for Wyoming. But the rest of the state looks more like this. Tons of open space and very few people. That means the schools out here are often very small, and they face a unique set of challenges in implementing next-generation science standards.
Wright Junior Senior High School, 40 miles south of Gillette, is a good example. It has some 200 students and only 3 science teachers.
One guy teaches 7th and 8th grade, one guy teaches 9, 10, I teach 11 and 12.
How'd you guys convert Celsius to Kelvins?
Small schools like Sarah Siemens can't support having specialists to teach just biology or physics. She has to do it all.
How many subjects do you teach here?
I teach 4 subjects. I teach anatomy, chemistry, environmental science, and physics.
And what's that like for you?
It's challenging. Some weeks I nail the chemistry and physics and maybe environmental science, and then my anatomy class, I neglect them.
What other number is gonna be bigger?
So then I gotta do really interesting things with anatomy, and then my chemistry class kind of falls off. At least that's how I feel.
With the new standards, teachers like Siemens will have to change not in one subject, but 4.
They've just told us it's coming, that it's on its way, and be prepared because things are going to change.
Ready or not, Wyoming is on the verge of adopting the new standards statewide, but with one big exception. This is coal country, and officials removed language that had emphasized the major role of human activities, such as fossil fuel combustion, when teaching students about the causes of global warming.
Changing the standards to prevent teachers from teaching what is clearly scientifically accepted, documented information is unfortunate. But the practices of science and the way that science is done and teaching students to be able to go out and ask their own questions, collect the evidence, and know how to engage in a scientific argument is very encouraging.
Today, Wyoming has put its modified standards out for public review. They could make it to the governor's desk for approval by late fall. In Campbell County, Wyoming, I'm John Tulenko of Education Week, reporting for the PBS NewsHour.